We are ready to start.
Once again,
we would like to welcome you here at the press conference of prime and backup crew of Expeditions 46 and 47. I'd like to remind you that the session of Interagency Commission here just ended, and the crew were recommended for further pre-launch training at Baikonur Cosmodrome. And I'd like to introduce you to the prime crew, the commander of Soyuz spacecraft TMA, Yuri Malenchenko, Russia, Roscosmos, flight engineer Timothy Copper, USA, NASA, flight engineer 2, Timothy Pick, United Kingdom, ESA, and the backup crew, Anatoly Ivanishin, the commander, flight engineer Takuya Onishi, Japan, JAXA, and Kathleen Robbins, flight engineer 2, USA, NASA. And the launch of Prime Crew is planned on December 15th. We are ready to start our press conference, and we would like to start with the first question, RIA Novosti, Alexander Kovalov. First of all, I would like to congratulate the Prime and both crews and the backup crews on completion of their training, and a traditional question to the commander, to Yuri Malenchenko. Yuri Ivanovich, what would you like to take as a mascot, as an indicator of gravity in space? And the question, the second question is about the birthday. How will you be congratulated on your birthday by your team aboard the station? Well, thank you. About the mascot, I have not decided yet. Thank you. So, for about the mascot, we have not decided yet what we're going to select. I think that we will make this decision at Baikonur before launch, and it will be clear then. And as far as my birthday goes, everything is quite simple here. I have experience with this. The list of invitees is also quite straightforward. There is really nothing complicated about this. We will somehow celebrate my birthday briefly in the working atmosphere, doing our job. And thank you. TASS agency Dmitry Strugavets, I would like to join my colleague in congratulating you. And I would also like to ask you if you are going to receive your birthday gift pre-launch, or it will be waiting for you here on Earth when you return. And then the second question, when are you planning to return? If I understand it correctly, the days have changed, and now you're supposed to return in June, and you have accumulated more than 600 days in space, and thus there will be more. You will be close to Gennady Padalka's record, and you will break Krikalev's record as well. So my question is, are you thinking already about your next space flight? So to set the new record in long-duration space flight. Well, as far as the gifts go, I'm not sure. Usually, these are a surprise for me, and you're not supposed to give them in advance. And hopefully, I'll receive them after my flight, if they don't forget, of course. And then about the future, I am not usually thinking about long-term future. Our pre-launch schedule is quite busy, and we have to focus on every single working day at a time. And indeed, it will be a very long-duration flight, more than 6 months. It has been extended by 1 month due to the adjustments in the program, and it will be quite complex, demanding, and interesting flight and expedition. So this is what I'm thinking about currently, and this is also the core of my work activities. I'm not thinking about the future flights yet. Thank you. Yekaterina Belovlasova, Russian space. Could you please tell us about your research program, experiments, what you will be focusing on, and also about the EVA, about the spacewalk? Are you going to go out with Sergei, and what objectives do you have for the spacewalk?
First off, I'll say a couple of words about our program while we're on board. We plan to be very busy while we're on board. Space Station is now an orbiting laboratory, and so there's lots of work for us to do. Also, two of the transport vehicles that come on board will bring new elements to Space Station, both the Beam, which is an inflatable module, as well as an international docking adapter, which sets the way for us to have a standard for crew vehicles in the future. And of course, all of us are well trained on the experiments on board, and we plan to be very busy.
Well, as far as the spacewalk goes, I can tell you that this will be EVA number 42, according to the Russian program, and we will do it together with Sergei Volkov, and we have five main objectives. They have to do with the science and testing certain technologies. First of all, objective number one, EXPOS-R. This is the name of the experiment. We're going to remove exposed samples of organic and biological materials. Then the next technological experiment is called restoration, restavracia. So we're going to test the technology of attaching thermal tapes. The next one is SKK, which is the removal of materials to study characteristics of thermal radiation covers. And then the next objective is called test. We are going to study micro destruction of elements of structure and the presence of microflora and microorganisms. Then the next experiment or study is called resilience or venosliwost. We are going to study how the space environment affects or influences the materials used in space. We're also going to perform inspection and photo and video imaging of the Russian segment. We're planning on installing soft handles that could be used in the future during spacewalks. So these are our main objectives. Good afternoon. This is Channel 360, Tatiana Pchelina. Yuri, I have a question for you. Yuri, you more than anyone else would know what it is like to be away from your family. Could you please tell us about that? Well, first of all, of course, it is difficult for everyone because all family members have their own responsibilities, and when somebody leaves, then the other family members have to share his or her responsibilities, and then there is work and then just personal things, because there is no close exchange of emotions, experience, etc. And in our family, we are actually used to it, so we are able to handle it, of course, given our experience, and I think that everything will be just fine in this regard.
I just wanted to ask you, has it always been your ambition to go into space, and now you're closer to realizing that, how do you feel? And a broader question, there's often been questions about funding for the International Space Station and questions over its future. Given the, particularly the difficult political situation now, how important do you think it is to maintain the ISS? Should we? Do we need to?
Do you want to translate the question? Thank you for the question. To answer the first part, yes. It has been an ambition since an early age to go to space. However, I then became a pilot and a test pilot, and really aviation became my passion for the majority of my career. So I was just very fortunate in 2008 when the European Space Agency had their selection process to be able to apply and to fulfill that early boyhood dream of becoming an astronaut. Yes, from an early age, and then in my teenage years, aviation became the passion. And to answer the second part of your question, the International Space Station really serves two main functions, and that's scientific research, research for the benefit of people back here on Earth, but also scientific research for future space exploration. And something else that really is inherent in what we do in the International Space Station is this international partnership, which has also been so successful and so important over a long period of time.
The second part of the question is the following. Is it necessary to maintain the ISS, and will be the technical support provided during the stay aboard the ISS? And Timpik says that currently there are several programs that are being implemented aboard the ISS, including scientific program, and they are intended to for the benefit of the Earth and for the purpose of future space exploration. And besides, Tim has mentioned the partnership between different states. He is particularly mentioning successful and productive cooperation.
International partnership and funding is extremely important, not just till 2024, the end of the space station, but also for the future of space exploration to the Moon, Mars, and beyond, ultimately.
Also, Tim continues to say that maintaining space station is important not just for the purpose of the station's life, and it is also important for future space exploration to the exploration of Mars and beyond. And then there is a question to the backup crew. Anatoly, what if there are abnormal situations, and God forbid, of course, will the prime crew, the backup crew be able to replace the prime crew? Well, I'm happy being a backup crew, but our main task at Baikonur is to see off the prime crew at Baikonur. You have been training for a long time, and I suppose that you have been able to get to know each other really well. Could you please tell us about your personal weaknesses and strengths, your interests, because you will have to spend a lot of time with each other far away from home.
Everything is quite positive. In fact, I think both Tim and I are quite honored to fly with such an experienced and calm commander of the Soyuz, and we look forward to working with him on board. I also consider myself quite fortunate to fly with Tim Peake, who is also very mild-mannered, easy to work with, and so competent. So in all respects, I feel very blessed to fly with these gentlemen.
Well, I would like to add that Tim Kopra is a NASA astronaut, and he has experience working in space aboard the ISS, quite significant experience, and it allows us to rely on him 100%. And Tim Kopra will be the station's commander during increment 47, and throughout this time, the time of our training, we have been able to get to know each other really well, and I have mentioned many times all the positive characteristics, and we haven't been able to find anything negative throughout this period of time, and we have learned to rely on each other to successfully complete all our objectives. Thank you.
As somebody who's about to fly to space for the first time, it's a huge honor to be able to fly with Yuri and Tim. As Tim Kopra said, Yuri is an extremely competent commander, extremely experienced, very professional, very calm, and I have really enjoyed learning from him. And Tim Kopra has offered many pieces of invaluable advice from his experience in space and also from his experience doing a spacewalk as well. I've thoroughly enjoyed my training with Tim and Yuri, and I now look forward to the next 6 months of flying in space with them.
Given the recent incident on the U.S. segment, are you planning a spacewalk to repair the channel that was damaged by an electrical short?
In particular, is working very hard to come up with a solution for fixing the sequential shunt unit, which is one of the problems with our electrical system. But to date, we don't have a specific time, and they're still working on the plan for us to be able to repair it.
We know that we have been working on this question with a lot of attention, and I know that there are issues with the electrical system. However, we do not have a specific planned time to repair this system. A question for the backup crew, Anatoly Alexeyevich. So you had to fly on Soyuz TMAM, if I am saying it correctly. So currently you will fly on Soyuz MS. What are the differences between the systems? What is the main challenge in learning the new system? And how do you feel about flying with two rookies? And what if they are unable to provide you the help you need in the volume that you require and that could have been provided by Russian cosmonauts? Well, these rookies, they do not have experience of space flight, but they're very experienced. I'm very confident in them, and I don't think that there would be any issues with that. Speaking about the spacecraft, we are quite busy before the launch of the crime crew, so we haven't been able to get started with studying the systems, and which we're planning to do once we return from Baikonur. And your family, your children, will be there at Baikonur to see you off? Have they seen it yet?
My wife and two children will be able to join us just a few days before launch and watch this very special event.
Yes, my family will be there as well, and it will not be the first time for them. They have seen it twice already, and it is a pleasure for them to be there each time.
Here now in Star City, and they will join me in Baikonur also.
Thank you for your answers. This completes our press conference, and I would like to ask the prime crew to